guys, I wanted to talk with you tonight about Joe Biden and his scheduled town hall in a week, less than a week, with Anderson Cooper and CNN. So, supposedly Joe Biden's first trip outside of D.C. since inauguration will be going to Milwaukee, Wisconsin, and doing a CNN town hall at the Pabst Theater. They will be discussing subjects such as the coronavirus and how it's being handled, as well as a returning to normalcy. So, why? I find it very interesting that, so CNN apparently has the sacred right to be the first to speak directly to the president. And who better than Anderson Cooper, the most, maybe the most polished and respected member of CNN, although the bar can be set pretty low. I can at least say that there's a warm, fuzzy feeling that despite everything that I know and feel about CNN, there is a warm, fuzzy feeling in the back of my mind by watching someone like Anderson Cooper, because although I'm in my late 20s, I've been seeing Anderson Cooper. He's been on CNN at least 10 years, and so he's become a news anchor type figure, a news person, whatever you want to call him. He's perhaps a without peer, and given that he's got this position, giving the debate, and so I think it's pretty suspicious, like, because why does CNN get the first grab at this, and how will CNN discuss things with Biden? Do you think that CNN is going to be tough on Biden? Did CNN get this position? Are they doing this with Biden because they're tough journalists who are going to grill him on a variety of things? Are they going to be tough on Joe Biden? Of course not. This is an opportunity for Biden to speak. CNN, whatever credibility CNN has, they're lending it to Biden as a way to speak out to the American people through them. And of course, I would be shocked if Anderson Cooper asked him anything remotely pressing and remotely tough. For instance, Joe Biden has already made multiple foreign policy blunders. I can say, at the very least, he's immediately engaging more in the Middle East, particularly in Syria and Afghanistan, and he's already made it clear to Iran, despite the fact that the United States pulled out of the Iran nuclear deal first, that Joe Biden will not re-enter the deal unless Iran reconfines itself within the boundaries of the deal before the U.S., even though the United States was the one to pull out of the deal first, and Iran only after being sanctioned and only as a reaction decided to start enriching uranium or whatever they do with nuclear weapons again. Not necessarily nuclear weapons, but definitely with nuclear energy. Joe Biden says that although we pulled out first, we're not going to be the ones who go back first. Let Iran be the first to do this. Joe Biden is not so in another way, it's not going to happen because there's no reason for Iran to. It makes no sense for Iran to come crawling back when it was the United States who was the one who pulled out of the deal to begin with. We should be the ones who are begging Iran to get back in the deal with us. We should be we should obviously be the first ones to. We should be the ones to extend the olive branch here, but we're not. Despite the fact that it was one of Obama's greatest foreign policy decisions, one of the greatest things that that Obama did is in foreign policy with John Kerry, Joe Biden doesn't seem interested in re-engaging in the Iran nuclear deal. So what I'm saying is I doubt those kind of questions are going to be asked. They're going to stick with Joe Biden's talking points, whatever returning to normalcy means, which is another almost Orwellian kind of term, you know, like what does returning to normalcy mean? Does it mean returning to returning to deregulation and corruption and endless war and continued censorship and living under a surveillance state and increasingly increasingly militarized police forces? Is that the kind of returning to normalcy we're going to see? Or is that the status quo we'd like to return to? Or is it simply the veneer of what it looks like, what a president is supposed to look like and sound like, and how he's supposed to be spoken of? A lot of that just comes down to how the media covers him. And I think that CNN is going to give Joe Biden a big sloppy wet kiss right on the cheek. But we'll see. So I think it's interesting that they chose they could have had this town hall right in D.C. They could have done it. Joe Biden doesn't even have to leave the White House. But they chose to go to Milwaukee, Wisconsin at the Pabst Theater. So they chose to do this in a swing state and at a at a place named after, like, So Milwaukee is, of course, it's a beer town, you know, it's, you know, like, I feel like they're trying to get kind of folksy, trying to roll up their sleeves and be like, all right, well, you know, we are going to reach out. This is our way of reaching out to regular people, and we're going to win over some of the common folk, you know, your average beer drinker in the Midwest. We're going to show that we care. Even though the average person around here, the Midwest is obviously very, very mixed. Joe Biden shouldn't even be able to show his face in the Midwest after his disastrous record and when it comes to. You know, his background of outsourcing and entering China into the World Trade Organization, he's got no business, like, visiting Wisconsin or anywhere in the Rust Belt after the devastation of some of his policy decisions and his colleagues of the and really the result of neoliberalism to begin with. The Midwest is an area that was largely left behind by politics, so it's interesting that he tries to go there first. But Wisconsin did hand him their electoral votes. He won Wisconsin, unlike Hillary Clinton. So it's just the symbolism behind it. Like this whole, like, okay, this is how things are done. You know, CNN, the number one name in news. This is the perception we have to have. CNN are the professionals. Anderson Cooper is a professional. Joe Biden is a serious president. That's why he's rolling up his sleeves and getting down in the dirt in Milwaukee, you know. And let's be fair: if Joe Biden is doing this in Pabst Theater in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, I think that Joe Biden needs to at least have a Pabst Blue Ribbon. If Joe Biden doesn't drink, like that should be a requirement that Joe Biden have a Pabst Blue Ribbon, because I wonder how many beers he's had in recent years, you know, or has he moved on to something a little bit more sophisticated? Well, but anyway, I think it's interesting that they chose this location. They're gonna throw him some softball throws right down the middle, and I'll be interested to see how that turns out. So this is on February 16th on CNN at 8:00 Eastern. So I guess we'll all see how that turns out. All right, thank you guys.